So good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Today, just to present myself, I'm Dr. Ali Uri. I'm the responsible for the microbiology division from Thermo Fisher Scientific in the Middle East. And when we talk about the microbiology division, it's mainly all what's related to microbiology, the microbiology dedicated for clinical, for pharmaceutical, and for food testing. And we talk about food testing, we have the traditional method, which is the media, and we have the rapid method when we talk about the PCR. Today, the subject that I will cover is the species identification and quantification. I will give a quick before, so when start, just a quick background and about this subject, when it's really started to have more noise about it. You all know about the scandal of horse meat in the UK, where a certain beef product, specifically the beef burger, sold in a number of supermarkets in Ireland and in UK, show the presence of horse meat. So in the meantime, the adulteration and authenticity of the meat started to take the headlines in Europe, in USA, in China, and around the world, and started to think more about testing and doing the species ID and processed meat. From Thermo Fisher Scientific, we captured this need, and we started a certain collaboration with certain institute like Imgen, a highly experienced company in genetics, to respond to the customer's need, which is the identification of the meat. To give you a little bit background and conservative estimation about the cost of food fraud worldwide per year, it's around 15 billion, and it touch around 10% of the commercial food. So 15 billion is huge. When we compare it like a company like Thermo Fisher, where our revenue is 17 billion, so it's almost the revenue of a full company with 50,000 employees. So the regulatory answer, directly in Europe, they started to think about regulatory, to do regulation for the meat species and the meat ID. It's the presence of the horse meat, and the regulation was the presence over 1% of the horse meat weight to weight should be reported. Okay, so this is the limit of reporting. This is according to European regulation. The presence of reporting, it's not only about horse meat, about any contamination as well, is the rule of thumb in the meat industry. And so far, the preferred method used, if I'm talking about Europe so far, till another method will come, and I know all the researchers and even us, we are always seeking about a new method, but for the moment, the real-time PCR is the preferred method used. So what are the concerns in the market that you are addressing? When all of us, we are customers, and when we are buying the meat, the first thing that I want to know is my meat is pure? So here it should be 1% level quantification is needed with the quantification of standard processed food. The second question is what stated is okay on the label? Because if we go back to the horse scandal, I mean, the horse meat is not harmful for eating, and there are certain countries where they eat the horse meat. But as a customer or a consumer, I have the right to know what I'm eating. Typically, it should not be called beef burger, it should be called horse burger. And if you know, name it horse burger, I'm not sure that you will buy it and eat it, unless if you really like it. So it's a question of adulteration as well. The other concern is my food free of pork for religion, halal or kosher background. So the other request, the other concern as well is my vegetarian food is free of meat. And I can tell you that certain tests has been made, and a lot of the claimed vegetarian food are not really vegetarian, they contain meat. In microbiology, it's the test of the pathogen and bacteria, and here we are about meat ID. So, but I will present it briefly just in the workflow and when we can fit the meat ID. So from the microbiology division in Thermo, we address all the workflow for testing, starting from the preparation of your the sample, the enrichment, the sample preparation, the detection and enumeration, and the contamination, the confirmation plus identification. The meat ID testing, it's only about detection and enumeration. That is a step as well for preparation, but we don't do sample enrichment. So quickly, when we address the food safety and the food testing, we need as well. And usually, the meat ID came part the identification and species identification. It came part of the workflow because anyway, you need to do as well the pathogen testing for the food and the meat. So we have the traditional method, and it's the ISO method that are the gold standard for testing. When we talk about it as the traditional media, we use selective media for certain pathogen and only the media. And after we do the identification and the confirmation to know that we have, like, for example, salmonella, listeria, whatever we have, and we do as well the quantification. This is the standard method. The problem with the standard method is a long method. The bacteria culture can take days. So the alternative method came, which is the PCR. It's used the PCR technique, and here we address the need of efficiency and the need of time to result, and we can let the customers or the food producers or even the food test lab to get the result faster. And here we talk about the real-time PCR when we have different offer for real-time PCR. I will not go through that. This is not the main subject of today. Also, we can do at the same time, as I mentioned, meat species, GMO testing, detect as well the viruses using the real-time PCR and the mastitis for milk. And we have also a certain customized solution to meet certain tests. Just to understand a little bit how it is. So usually, you have the sample. You receive the sample. You need to do the enrichment. So we take the sample. We wait it. After we do the sample enrichment, we use dehydrated media. I'm talking about here about the microbiology. The second step is to do the sample preparation. And if we are doing the DNA testing, which is the genetic testing, we need to extract the DNA to be able to test it. So typically, when we are just to summarize it, when we are using the traditional method, we do the culture for bacteria and we use selective media to show those bacteria. Only those bacteria will be grown. And if we have them, if we see them, it means if there is colony developing, it means that the bacteria is here. And we can use certain method like chromogenic agar that gives certain color to the bacteria and we know this is listeria, this is salmonella, etc. When it's up to the alternative method, we need to detect it in a different, and we detect the DNA. So to detect the DNA, we need to extract this DNA. So we do the DNA extraction. We can do it manually, or we can do automated method for extraction. After we need to do the detection, we use a PCR, which is a polymerase chain reaction. It's to amplify the DNA. The DNA, it's present. We know it's present, but to be able to detect it, we need to amplify it to be able to see it. We can use other method, which is the ELISA-based method. It's for other kind of detection, like allergen detection, and for sure the traditional method of chromogenic and culture media. Confirmation and identification, once we have the positive result, we need to confirm it. So when we confirm it, we can go back to traditional method, which is the gold standard method for detection. When it's negative, we can release the product. So negative, that's sure. Negative, we can go ahead. When it's positive, we need to confirm it. We use there is different kind of technique that we can use it. Part of it is biochemical identification, agglutination sera, and real-time PCR or quality control organism. Right now, back to our subject. So part of our portfolio for food authenticity testing is the meat speciation, and here we use the real-time PCR method. So here the aim is to detect and quantify. So it's not only about detecting and quantifying, because again, the regulatory or the standard use is if we have over 1% presence weight to weight, it should be reported. So here we need to quantify it. So detect and quantify the traces of beef, fish, pork, equine, for example, and meat and feed samples. the method is PCR-based method. We have the GMO testing, and while I will not go through it, it's based as well on PCR, and we have the allergen detection. It's different method. It's different method, and it's based on ELISA, where it's antigen against, antibodies against antigen detection. For the portfolio, we have, without going to commercial name, but it's Rapid Finder Beef ID Kit, Chicken ID, Pork, Turkey, Sheep, Poultry, and Remnant Fish. And also we have the Quant Multi Meat Test, which is for the total quantity of the meat present. I'll go right now. I'll not go technically in detail for technical. I will present the workflow briefly, but please, if you have any question later on, feel free to ask. Again, let's say we have our sample. We need to do the workflow. First, we need to isolate the DNA. We use the DNA extraction method, and it's the same that we use it for the GMO extraction. We extract the DNA. After the extraction, we need to use the kit, which is the real-time PCR kit for species ID. And once we do it, we need to compare to a standard. So we have inside the kit, we have a control to quantify and to know if we have over 0.1% meat species. So let's say in this case, we are testing the horse meat or like pork. We do the DNA, we see if first presence or non-presence, and after how much it is present. So if positive, we will quantify. So first we see we do the detection, and if we detect it, we do the quantification. And when it's to quantification, we combine two tests, the specific test and the multi-meat quant test quantification. So we run meat specific and general animal product reaction separately, and we compare to a standard curve. When we talk about here, it's a little bit technical, but it's the way how we quantify with real-time PCR. Extraction, briefly about the extraction. We have the sample, so usually we weigh 20 grams of the sample. We do homogenization of the sample. It's safe. There is no toxic. There is no toxic material inside. And after, it's reliable method. So we remove the inhibitors for the PCR, and the isolation method is pure, so we can test as well the DNA extraction. It's easy to use and with minimal handling steps. So 2 hours to do this extraction. Usually we have, as I mentioned, we homogenize our sample. After we add the lysis buffer. The lysis buffer is to open the cells and to make the DNA available, exposed. After the second lysis buffer, because we want to, it's proteinase K to digest all the proteins around to not have any inhibition on the PCR reaction. We do the spin and we have our DNA ready for testing. Here we use the species kit, and the kit can do 48 reactions, so we can do 48 tests. It's the detection of mitochondrial DNA. The kits include, for sure, we need a positive control. So it's consisting of 0.1% of target DNA, the target that we are looking for. We have the target DNA master mix and the general master mix. It's easy to use. So when we talk about real-time PCR, just briefly, it's for quantification, detection and quantification of the DNA. When we talk normal PCR that you heard about, it's PCR only to amplify the DNA, it's qualitative. So we can say yes or no, we have or we don't have the DNA, the specific DNA for this virus, for this bacteria, or for this meat species. And to quantify it, we need the second technique, which is the real-time PCR. It's a reliable method. It's widely used, and even in diagnostic and in clinical, it's used for virus detection. And we have, in this method, we use internal positive control to know if it's our method is, or the kit is really working. And the sensitivity is high. We can detect down to 0.01%. Although the bioregulation, everything above 0.1% should be reported, but we can go lower to 0.01%. And even right now, we have other alternative method. It's more on the research for digital PCR, where we can go lower on this limit. And this is more related to GMOs, because GMOs, we need the deeper or lower limit of detection. So we need more sensitive techniques. Here we'll talk about the species quantification. So let's say we have a positive call. We know that pork, we have the pork, and we need to quantify it. We need to know how much there is pork and weight-to-weight ratio in our tested food. So simply, we have done the species DNA testing, and we do the total DNA testing. And we do just divide it and multiply it by 1%, and we have the percentage of species by DNA. Okay, so we have the, let's say there is a pork inside our meat. We test, we know how much we have DNA for the pork. We do as well, because when we do the PCR, it's specific, it will only detect the pork and it will only detect the horse meat or only detect our target, but it will not detect the total value. If we now want to quantify, we want to know how much there is, so we need to know how much there is total DNA in our sample, which is the 20 gram. And here we can have the percentage, and we can say that it's 100%, there is 50% pork, there is 20%, and etc. What are the benefits of using this technique? It's a real-time PCR-based technique. It's a rapid method, so the test can be done within hours, 2 hours from preparation, and let's say 30 minutes, sometimes 45 minutes to get the result, and it's fast. The DNA extraction, we have the full workflow in our method from DNA extraction. We are a company, and we have all the workflow. The detection of mitochondrial DNA is a very high sensitive method. Quantification is based on two absolute quantification using standards, and it's accurate for food, and we have reliable answer at the end. It's the percentage of species in the total DNA, animal DNA. To conclude, Thermo Fisher Scientific and food safety, what we are presenting is a full workflow for food safety testing. We are a pioneer company in when it's related to molecular biology, and it's based on our experience from our brand Applied Biosystem, or previously known as Life Technology. We have a new innovative method, and it will be coming soon regarding sequencing, bioinformatic expertise, and innovative other solutions. And our method is used worldwide, and in the region we have a food lab and reference food lab that they are using our solution. I can name Qatar, for example. The simplicity of our workflow is one of our advantages. We have single shop place going beyond pathogen. When you do food microbiology or food testing, you need to do pathogen, but you need to do meat authenticity virus testing, and we can offer all this portfolio. We have a broad range of PCR and even custom real-time PCR solution. The efficiency, when we talk about molecular biology, we all know that the trend is going to molecular biology because it's faster time to result. And when we talk about it, there is validation behind it. It's not only test, it's tested and validated. And the flexibility, we have our system, they are open system, and you can use it for other, along with other kind. As well, to mention that this is a good point, that our data are validated. It's not that we have done, the data is validated. Validation report are available. The chicken ID, pork ID. This is to prove the request about the specificity, so it's specific test, sensitivity, limit of detection. We have proof of limit of detection, and reproducibility and repeatability for the testing. Thank you very much for your attention.